Hey guys, it's Lish from Devilish Angel. Today I'm going to show you how to make this cute two-piece set. And I finally figured out how to add music to my videos, so you know, enjoy. Using the soft stretchy fabric, and in all honesty, I think I just like this fabric because it had a beauty mark on the face, and I have one on my face too. Anyways, these are the two pieces I'm using for my pattern, a top and then a skirt pattern that I had already made. I always cut any straps that I may need out first, so I'm just cutting a long strap that is an inch wide for the bottom part of the skirt to ruche it. By the way, this is the first time I ever made a set like this, so I am kind of just winging it this whole time, but it did come out very cute in the end, so you know, just trust me. So now I'm going to cut out my skirt pattern. So I'm going to cut out two pieces like this, and anytime you're going to ruche an item, you always want it a little longer than you actually want the skirt, because it's gonna get shorter when it is ruched. So here I am just cutting out the second skirt piece, and you always want to test the stretch of your fabric, so whichever way is stretchier, you want that to go across your body, that way it's easy to put the skirt on and take it off. So here I'm measuring how long the skirt is, because I will cut a strip that is an inch and a half wide and just a couple of inches longer than the actual skirt. So I usually add like 2 inches to the skirt length. And this is the part that I'm going to sew on the inside of the skirt to make the channels for the ruching. For the top, I just laid it out flat and traced around the edges, adding about 1/4 inch for seam allowance. So I used a ruler when I cut out the top to get a perfectly straight cut. So I'm going to cut out the sides and the back piece, leaving the middle part still attached. And I'm going to put a pin on the top of that line and then at the bottom. That way I know where to fold it. So I'm just going to fold it over till I see like the pins are in the middle, and then cut it out. That way the top is perfectly symmetrical. So now that everything's cut out, it's time to start pinning and sewing. So I'm first going to pin along the sides of the skirt with the fabric's right sides together. So once those two sides are pinned together, I'm going to sew those two along with the strap. So I'm just going to fold the strap in half and sew along that side. And I am using a serger, but if you don't have a serger, you could always add just a little more seam allowance and sew with the zigzag stitch on a regular sewing machine. And since this fabric is stretchy, make sure that you don't pull it while you're sewing, otherwise it's gonna look like wrinkly and wavy. So here I am just sewing the strap, and I do always like to add this clear elastic for my straps. I don't know why, it just makes it so much nicer, and like the strap won't like the seam won't break if you pull it. So I always add this clear elastic. The link for it is in the description. And again, if you don't have a serger, you can just add a little more seam allowance and sew with the zigzag or hem stitch on a regular machine. And now I'm just gonna turn the strap right side out with my strap turner. The link for the strap turner is also in the description. For the skirt, I'm just gonna take this 1/2 inch elastic and add it to the top where the waistband is, that way it fits snug on my waist. So I'm just gonna lay it along the edge and serge it, and then fold it over and sew it down with the zigzag stitch. So here I am just serging it on, and usually I might pull it just like very, very, very slightly. That way I can make sure it'll fit snug and not loose, but you don't wanna pull it too much or else it'll be super scrunched. Now I'm just going to get my bobbin ready with the matching thread, and then I'm going to fold over the top edge of the skirt and sew that down with the zigzag stitch. I really like using the 3-point zigzag stitch, which is like the dotted zigzag stitch on the machine. And now I'm just going to hem the bottom of the skirt by folding it over about 1/2 inch and also sewing that down with the zigzag stitch. And again, for this part, just make sure you don't stretch the fabric while you're sewing, otherwise your hem will come out looking wavy. So now it's time to add the ruching part. So I'm just going to put the skirt inside out, and then I'm going to mark a line directly down the middle. So I just use a measuring tape to find the middle and put like little dots just by measuring across the skirt and dividing that in half and then connecting those dots with the ruler so it's a perfectly straight line down the middle. So the strip that I cut for the ruching, I like to hem the top of it real quick, which I already did, and then I'm just going to pin it directly along that line, trying to like make it even in the middle. So I kind of just like pin it and then check to see if I pinned it on the line, because I want it to be right in the middle. And then I will sew right down the middle with a straight stitch and then add another straight stitch onto both sides of that line about a half an inch out. That way I have two channels for the ruching. So here I'm just doing the line down the middle and I'm sewing it with the straight stitch, and I'm back stitching in the beginning and at the end, and I always make sure to back stitch like a couple times, that way it's secure. And then I just line the middle stitch up with the footer and I sew another straight stitch about a half an inch or like a centimeter out from the middle stitch, and then I'm going to do the same for the other side. So once that's done, I'm just gonna trim off the bottom excess and then feed my strap through the strap channels so that both of the strings will come out at the bottom, and then I can ruch it. And I ended up adding another ruching to the back, that way the front and the back are ruched. I just feel like it complements the body a lot when both sides are scrunched up. So I'm gonna hem the bottom of the shirt with a straight stitch, but you don't want to go all the way back because we do need to connect it. So I put like a half an inch mark out, but I ended up not sewing all the way back. Well, I ended up taking out the stitch later in the video because you need to make part of it with like a zigzag stitch, that way it will stretch over your body and the seam won't pop. But yeah, so here I'm just doing a straight stitch on the bottom, but I left about 3 or 4 inches on each side, that way I can add elastic later so it will stretch better. I hope that makes sense. So once I did one side, I'm just gonna flip it over and do the other. So here I'm just kind of doing like a quality check. So I put the shirt up against my body and realized it was kind of long, so I'm gonna trim off about an inch and a half from the top. And then I'm gonna put the ends of the shirt together and sew these. So I'm gonna connect the shirt now by sewing this part. So here I'm just connecting that back piece of the top. I'm going to add elastic to the top of the shirt the same way I did to the top of the skirt, by attaching it with my serger and then folding it over with a zigzag stitch. And I'm also going to add a little bit to that back piece. So I seam ripped it a little bit and added it. That way the shirt will now stretch and the bottom part won't pop. And if you guys have any questions at all during the tutorial, just comment them down below, or even feel free to DM me on Instagram. I do offer one-on-one sewing classes personalized to you via Zoom or in person. So once the elastic is attached, I just fold it over and sew it down with a zigzag stitch. And I do this for the top and then that little piece on the bottom part where I attach the elastic. So here was the final product. It was super comfy, very cute, easy to put on, and as you can see here in the back, so that's where I added the elastic and the zigzag, and then the rest is the straight stitch, so I hope that makes sense. And yeah, hope you guys liked this video. As always, if you have any questions, just comment them down below and I'll answer any questions you guys have. And here is me in it, so you can see what it looks like on. I know I never show myself in videos. But yeah, thanks for watching, and if you guys want to see more tutorials and more of my work, you can follow me on Instagram @devilishangel.